In this video, I will solve summer 2014 MAC past paper question for linear programming. The question is relevant for BFD as well as MAC and MSc exams. Let us solve the question. The question says a company manufactures two products, alpha and beta. There are two products, alpha. Let's represent alpha with X and beta, and let us represent beta with Y. It says alpha can only be used. Now this is a very crucial statement to form first inequality. It says alpha can only be used in combination with beta in the ratio of 4:1 respectively. The only use of alpha is with beta. It cannot be used separately. Beta has separate uses also. Now beta can be used separately as well. So these two lines form our first inequality, in which students generally have confusion. Let us form an example. Let's say I produced 1 unit of beta. How many units of alpha will I produce? Point to note is that beta has separate uses also. So if I have produced this 1 beta to be used separately, to be used in some way not in combination with alpha, I will never produce alpha. But if the intention of production of this beta was to use it with alpha, I will definitely produce 4 alphas. Let's repeat this example. Let's say I produce 2 betas. Now beta has separate uses as well. So there is a possibility that I produce these 2 betas to be used somewhere not with alpha. Therefore, how many alphas will I produce? 0, if my intention to use these betas separately. But what if I produce 2 betas, 1 to be used separately and 1 to be used with alpha? Now how many alphas will I produce? I will produce 4 alphas. And what if I produce both betas to be used with alpha? I will produce 8 alphas. So the first thing is coming out of these two lines, which is the first inequality. And how do we draft this inequality? We have represented alpha with X and beta with Y. Simply in exams, write X over Y or X is to Y is equals to 4:1, which is the ratio of alpha is to beta. Cross multiply, this will be X is equals to 4Y. Once you derive this form from the 4:1 ratio which was provided in question in using basic maths, now you have two choices. You will think that either my inequality should be x is less than or is equals to 4y, or my inequality should be x is greater than or is equals to 4y. Now use this example to brainstorm and think what can be the possible inequality. Let's say that this is the true inequality. What is it saying? It's saying that X or alpha will be less than or is equals to. X or alpha will be either less or equals to 4 times my beta. And in fact, it is true. How? We just worked out that if I produce 1 beta, I will either produce 0 alphas or I will produce 4 alphas. So let's say if my y or if my beta is 1, this will become x is less than or is equals to 4:1, which is x is less than or is equals to 4. And this means that if my y is 1, if I am reducing 1 beta, I will produce less than or is equals to 4 alphas, which is true because either I will produce 4 alphas or I will produce 0 alphas. So this cannot be my inequality. My true first inequality is x is less than or is equals to 4y, which was the first new thing in this question. The rest of the equations are really simple to form. Let's read the question and form the equations. It further says that projected information per unit for the next year is as follows. You are provided with certain information. You are provided with selling price, material cost, variable manufacturing costs, applied fixed overheads. Remember, applied fixed overheads are not used to calculate contribution. machine hours, labor hours, and then it says that the available capacity for the next year is 40,000 machine hours. The limit on machine hours is given. So we can form a machine hours equation, and it will be, since alpha is represented by pi, like any other question, it will be 5x plus 4y is less than or is equals to 40,000. It further says that labor hour limit is 30,000. Therefore, my second inequality of labor hours would be what? 3x plus 6y is less than or is equals to 30,000, as we have done in so many questions so far. Now it says that machine time costs 320 rupees per hour and labor is 140 rupees per hour. These values are given so that we can compute our contribution and objective function. Lastly, it says that the maximum demand for alpha is 6,000 units. Beta has unlimited demand. So we will have one more inequality, which is x, or the production of alpha will be less than or is equals to 6,000 rupees. Sorry, 6,000 units. So our inequalities are x is less than or is equals to x is less than or is equals to 4y, x is less than or is equals to 6,000, 5x plus 4y is less than or is equals to 40,000, 3x plus 6y is less than or is equals to 30,000. Now you can plot these inequalities on a graph and find the feasible region. Let us calculate the amount of contribution as well. The contribution amount is obviously sales revenue less all variable costs. So for alpha, our sales revenue per unit is provided as 6800, and for beta it is 5800. So 6800 and for beta 5800 less all variable costs. And our variable costs are for material 3500 and 2600. For variable manufacturing overheads, 380 and 340. For applied fixed overheads are ignored. And then we are given machine hours. Alpha uses 5 machine hours, beta uses 4 machine hours, and the cost of each machine hours is given as 320. Therefore, it should be 5 multiplied by 320, and this one should be 4 multiplied by 320, the cost of machine hours. Plus, we are given with labor hours. Alpha uses 3 labor hours and beta uses 6 labor hours. The cost of labor hour is 140 rupees provided below the table, and therefore the next cost will be 3 into 140 and 6 into 140. There is no other variable cost left behind. So we will subtract all the variable cost and calculate the contribution per units. And the contributions will come out to be 6800 minus 3500 minus 380 minus 5 into 320 minus 3 into 140. Which is 900, and the next one will be 5800 less 2600 less 340 less 4 into 320 less 6 into 140. So it will be 740. And therefore, our objective function for this question will be contribution is equals to 900x plus 740y. So if we have found out all the inequalities and our objective function, is 900x and 7 plus 740y, and listing out all our inequalities, 5x plus 4y is less than or is equals to 40,000, 3x plus 6y is less than or is equals to 30,000, x is less than or is equals to 4y, x is less than or is equals to 6000, and two non-negativity constraints, x should be greater than or is equals to 0, y should be greater than or is equals to 0, since x and y both are units. In part 2 of this video, I will be drawing the graph and continue with the solution of this question. Thank you for watching part 1.